this video, I'm going to show you one way in which Xplane 12 is greatly improved over Xplane 11. I saw a developer's website where he talked about modeling entrainment. And this is where it began. This is an F4 Phantom flying in Xplane 11. And people who had already flown this aircraft began to question why it needed to get up to nearly 200 knots before it rotated on takeoff. And that led to the discovery of entrainment, and we'll see how it's improved in Xplane 12. And it's affected all aircraft. Even before we get to the takeoff, they found that they had modeled the fuel tanks incorrectly in Xplane 11. If you look here, there's just two or three fuel tanks, and they're not really in the right place in Xplane 11, and that was one thing that was affecting the plane. But this is specific to the F4 Phantom, and it's separate from the entrainment issue. So this, as you will see later, has been corrected in Xplane 12. So we'll do a proper takeoff with full flaps. Here we go. We'll do the same takeoff here that we'll do later in Xplane 12. Here in Xplane 11, we'll bring the engine up to 85% power. At that point, we have to release the parking brake. Then we'll spool it up to close to 100% power. And when it gets there, we'll jam on the afterburner and pull the stick all the way back and hold it there until it rotates. I will freeze the frame when it rotates, and you can check it's very close to 200 knots. Now here is Xplane 12, and look at the number of tanks going down the center line of this plane. They're all behind the pilot and above the engine, and they're correct. Now here's what I understand entrainment is. Now apparently, as this blast of hot air coming out of the afterburner shoots back from the engine, it drags with it a lot of the surrounding air around that red hot area. And as you can see, the elevator is right above that hot blast of the afterburner. And apparently the elevator catches a lot of that entrained air that's being caught by this rushing hot gas coming out of the engine and being pulled back along with it. So basically the elevator has a lot of authority or upward or downward force at the tail from the entrained air that's flowing over it, and this was not modeled properly in Xplane 11. It is being modeled correctly for all aircraft in Xplane 12, and therefore the behavior will change slightly and be even more realistic than it was in Xplane 11. So let's do a takeoff here, just like we did in Xplane 11. We'll do one in Xplane 12 and see at what speed we rotate. I think you're going to get entrainment even without an afterburner, just not as much. Okay, here we go. Flaps down two notches. ...85% power, release the brake, advance throttle to nearly 100% power, then light the afterburner, pull the stick all the way back, and hold it there. Again, as I did in Xplane 11, I'm going to freeze the frame when the aircraft rotates, and you can check the speed. It's going to be much closer to 150 knots. Here's the replay of the takeoff, 85% power, take the brakes off, 100% power, afterburner, elevator full back, and it's not a particularly good takeoff, it's one of my first ones on Xplane 12, but all the same, I hope you enjoyed this video and you like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.